The team came together for an emotional 1-0 victory in New Jersey the next night. But after coughing up a shutout and a win in the final minute in Carolina, and another listless performance at home against the Devils, the players had a closed-door meeting to air their grievances. Since then, it's been a whole different team. Claude Giroux scored for the first time this season in a 4-2 win against Edmonton. The team then hit the road, first blanking the Senators 5-0, and then knocking off their hated rival Penguins 2-1 behind two Braden Schenn goals and a great performance in net by Ray Emery. The team finished off the road trip with a gritty effort in Winnipeg before losing in a shootout. Still, getting 5 of a possible 6 points was good enough as they arrived back in Philadelphia for a 3-game homestand. Win or lose, one guy who is always there with positive support is equipment manager Derek Settlemyer. A longtime team employee, Derek learned the trade as a teenager under his father, Dave Sudsy Settlemyer, the team's manager in the 1980s.
When I started, I was fortunate enough to get a job right out of college, and the first few months I was getting worked so hard by him, I didn't know if I really wanted to do this. I was kind of shaking my head at everything he had me doing, but that's the way you want to do things. You want to do everything perfect. You want the guys to come in and not have to worry about anything but playing hockey. The main thing is just trying to give the guys energy when they're coming out to the rink. And you know, you could be, you know, having a tough stretch like we are now, but you don't want to be moping around the locker room, and you know, as energetic as you can, just to hopefully that rubs off on them, you know.
Here we go.
There's a few different guys. We have a few different things we do. I give the two Schenn brothers an elbow each, and me and Zach Rinaldo have a little punch thing where he swings at me and Doc, and me and Scott Hartnell do a little, we call it the bird feeder, because he's, you know, we call him the bird dog. It's me and Wayne Simmons. We like to see who can jump higher. He's got skates on and still outjumps me by quite a bit, but Braden Coburn comes by and he just does something strange every day. I really don't know what he's gonna do. I just kind of try to copy what he's doing.
Here we go. Oh yeah. Go. Come on, Rashad. Oh yeah. Woo. Oh yeah. Come on here.
The first home game for the resurgent Flyers would again be against Ottawa, who would be looking to avenge the shutout loss at home from a week earlier. Jumped out to a 2-goal lead, only to watch it fade away as the Sens tied it. Earlier this season, the Flyers would have wilted under this pressure, but no longer.
Three will head off to Timonen. Timonen cuts in front and scores! What a rebound, Schenn! And it bounced high in the air, now back out for a Simmons shot. He scores! Bang, bang, and just like that, it's 4-2.
Yeah, that's a penalty shot. And this is a big, big save coming here, hopefully from Steve Mason.
On the next episode of Flight Plan, presented by Virtua. The Flyers stay hot against Buffalo and finish the homestand against the Islanders. Vinny LeCavalier goes back to Tampa, and Scott Hartnell hosts a dinner for his Hartnell Down Foundation.